In this video, we'll determine several function values using a piecewise defined function. When working with piecewise defined functions, it's important to pay close attention to the domain or x values for each piece of the function. For example, f of x is equal to 2x plus 1 if x is less than or equal to 1, and f of x is equal to negative 3x plus 2 if x is greater than 1. So depending on which interval the given value of x is in, it will affect which function rule we use. So to evaluate f of negative 3, we first want to determine whether negative 3 is less than or equal to 1 or greater than 1. Well, obviously, negative 3 is less than or equal to 1, which means we'll use the function rule f of x equals 2x plus 1 to determine this function value. So replacing x with negative 3, we would have 2 times negative 3 plus 1, which is equal to negative 6 plus 1, which is equal to negative 5. f of negative 3 is equal to negative 5. To evaluate f of 2, we first want to determine whether positive 2 is less than or equal to positive 1 or greater than 1. And since 2 is greater than 1, we're going to use the function rule f of x equals negative 3x plus 2 to determine this function value. So we'll substitute positive 2 for x. So we have negative 3 times positive 2 plus 2. So we have negative 6 plus 2, which is equal to negative 4. F of 2 is equal to negative 4. And then for our last example, we have f of 1. So again, we first want to determine whether positive 1 is less than or equal to positive 1 or greater than 1. Notice 1 is where we have a break in the function, but because when x is less than or equal to 1, it includes positive 1, we're going to use the first function rule to evaluate f of 1. So we would have 2 times 1 plus 1, which is 2 plus 1 or positive 3. F of 1 is equal to positive 3. Let's also take a look at this graphically. Here's the graph of the piece-defined function. When x is less than or equal to 1, this should be the graph of our function. And when x is greater than 1, this should be the graph of our function. Notice we have an open point when x equals 1 on this piece of the function. Notice f of negative 3 equals negative 5 corresponds to this point here, where the coordinates are negative 3, comma, negative 5. F of 2 equals negative 4 corresponds to this point here, where the coordinates are 2, comma, negative 4. And then for f of 1 equals 3, notice there's a break in the graph at x equals 1, but because this point is open and this point is closed, the function is defined at this point here. Notice the coordinates are 1, comma, 3. Okay, that's going to do it for this example. Thank you for watching.